is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
From what day you may find out, certain people not like me. Everyone got a spaghetti now. Makes true me, I do it like Nike.
Talking Heads with Naughty is brought to you by BTC, Burger King, the Cancer Treatment Centers of America, Fine Threads, First Caribbean Bank, Foreign Currency, John's Department Store, Joker's Wild, KFC, Naughty Johnny's, Percy's Island Games, Scotiabank, Sun Oil Limited, and Tropical Gyros.
Me just a do it like Nike. Them one pies in me, throw me thing up. Pass me and them girlfriend a link up.
Hello.
Dark way you did that when the thing tough. No food, clean water for drink up. Now me and the dog, them a link up. Big truck, 20 inch rim, just a spin up.
And good afternoon, good day. Sure happy it's Thursday. This is Talking Heads Thursday with your boy Pearly in the house. You'll notice I don't say filling in for Naughty no more on a Thursday, right? Because this is Pearly. So happy to have you here with me. But this weather really playing havoc on us. I was cold last night. And people just tease me, oh, you from Minnesota? You been to school in Minnesota and I used to get cold? That was many, many moons ago. My blood turn out now. But I hope everybody's doing good. Let's see what's happening in the Guardian this morning. New bail proposal after bail breach. New bail possible after bail breach. Judge to use discretion in deciding whether to grant new bail application. Same problem we have now. Anyway, Davis defends contract to people on bail. Woman murdered in triple shooting. DPM confident foreign media reports won't harm country. I don't know about that. I just finished cussing some people on TikTok. This woman is talking bad with my country. And I say, you don't have to be a bail POF in them. You got to be a Bahamian first. And I laid into them. Another part of the Guardian, Adrian Gibson argues against bail act changes. Former AG, systematic changes are needed. I agree. And in the business section, the Ministry of Finance apologizes for faulty DIR platform. Watson, we are in the process of speaking directly with the vendor to see how quickly we can mitigate some of the challenges. Just doing that? Anyway. White, new system was broke on January 1 at launch and still broke on January 31st. I would think if you're launching, you'll have the people here to make sure everything runs smooth. But I guess, I mean, that's only me. Tourism working to reverse cruise line Freeport to Florida ticket ban. Bahamas Air, new 737 Boeing plane cleared for its U.S. flights. You know the question I have for that? How much money we had to pay to hang your people have that sitting over there all that time for the inspection? I won't know that money. I hear some astronomical figures. BTC restores customer affected by network sabotage on Grand Bahama. And lastly, Concept for Performing Arts School launched 2026 opening night. Wonderful. That is good news. So, I hope everybody's good. I ain't in that mood today. I might be a little rowdy today. I can try to keep it sober rowdy, though. Now, you know, for the last week, I've been doing Z Live and then on Thursdays, Talking Heads. And we've been talking about crime. We talked about capital punishment, corporal punishment. And then yesterday, we had a really, really good conversation about the family. So I said, you know, what can we do today to kind of keep the dialogue going, but a way to come up with some new solutions? And one of the things that dawned on me is we ain't talking to the young people. We're not asking the young people what they think about their country. We're not asking the young people why young people are not interested in doing more than just making money. Why they're not interested in politics. Why they're not interested in church. Why they're not interested in a lot of things. So I said, let me get two young people. I actually had a third one, but the third one couldn't make it. Let me get a couple of young people under the age of 30 who can give me their idea of what's going on. Now, I thought about calling my churn. I said, but you know, I think I'm being a little biased by bringing Trey, Vincey, and Avery. So I said, you know what? Let me get some other young people. So two people I have a beautiful young lady in the studio with me, and I'm only going to tell you her first name. I ain't no last name today. I'll tell you them later. Hannah. Welcome, Hannah.
Hi. Thank you for having me.
Sound good, eh? Boy, you should see her. And then I have a nice young man who's on the Zoom call. His name is Xavier. Xavier, welcome to Talking Heads.
It's a pleasure to be here.
So, Xavier, while I got you, yesterday I spoke about and said, are we losing the family in this country? Are we losing our young people? And I know a lot of the crimes that are going on been affecting young men and women. And I don't want to look at it like that. Are young people just not interested anymore?
Well, Earl, I wouldn't say that young people aren't interested.
By the way, my radio name is Pearly. Don't call my real government
Pearly.
Name.
Pearly.
Uh-huh.
Pearly.
Yes.
I wouldn't say young people, we're losing young people.
Uh-huh.
Well, we are losing young people to crime.
Uh-huh.
Definitely, we've seen in recent days and months where a lot of young persons under the age of 30, young men, a few young women, have been lost to gun violence and so forth in the country. But the problem we have is that young people are just aren't interested in what they see especially in the political sphere. They're disconnected. They don't feel that policymakers have their best interests at heart, and so they are disconnected from that. But we have to do our best ensuring that we provide the environment for young people in this country to succeed.
Hannah, what is it that young people want? What does young people want? Just want? Do they just want a job? They want to be entrepreneurs? What is it you feel that young people want? As a young lady under the age of 30, what is it you want?
I feel as if nowadays, especially times before, people just want to be successful. A lot of persons just want that sense of independence. I know, I've heard growing up that back in the day, persons were used to being handed things from their members of parliament and other persons. But especially with social media playing an intricate part in things, people just want to earn their keep, and also to be able to afford the lifestyle that they want. And unfortunately, a lot of people nowadays, not a lot of persons, but some persons are trying to accomplish that lifestyle in ways that are against the law. But I think that's what a lot of young people want. They just want to be successful. They want to be independent, and they have a vision for how they want to live their life.
Xavier, she said two key words just now: social media. And somebody said, "Man, all these young people interested in this TikTok and eating and drinking. Is social media helping or hurting?" I know it's an intricate part of a lot of what you do for a living. What I do, and a lot of what people in terms of marketing, branding their products, but is social media, particularly TikTok, Facebook, X or Twitter, but being formerly known as Twitter. See, I get in there, and Snapchat. That's the one I was trying to remember. Are we losing our young people to just wanting to be on their phones, on their tablets, looking at these things all day?
I wouldn't say we're losing our young people to social media, because I'm depending on who the person is. They use social media for various things. You have young entrepreneurs that use social media to make money. They use it to market their products and their services so that they can be able to feed themselves and feed their families.
Okay.
You have some people that use social media, obviously, to learn. And we see with TikTok nowadays, people are using it. They go into TikTok to find out how to cook. They go into TikTok to find out how to do various activities or things that they would like to be a part of. But then there are some people that they get the bad side of social media, where they are tuning into things on social media that doesn't benefit them generally. And so I think depending on the person, people use social media for various different things.
Okay.
You just have to be mature enough or conscious enough to know that this is what you need to use social media for and what you really should stray away from, especially when you're using it for gossiping and drama, unnecessary drama.
Well, I use TikTok for two things. One, I want to see them pretty girls. And the second one, I was talking to a young friend the other day, and I told her I was looking for a recipe. And she said, "Where are you looking?" I said, "Again, on Pinterest." "No, nobody uses Pinterest anymore. Go on TikTok. All the recipes are on TikTok." So when you said that to me, it kind of piqued my interest now. Hannah, is people out of Pinterest and just into TikTok?
I feel as if Pinterest is just used for visions and the aesthetic and, trying to plan things like that.
But I thought you'd say that's for us old people.
No, but not a lot of persons are really interested in Pinterest no more. But TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook are the primary social media platforms that persons use.
You agree with that, Xavier? Did we lose it?
I definitely agree with that.
Okay.
People love Instagram. They love TikTok. I don't hear a lot of people using Snapchat that much.
No, not Snapchat.
I don't know.
I only thought about it. I'm telling you my age, and I just thought about that.
I definitely don't use Snapchat at all. I don't even have the app anymore.
Okay.
I don't know if I'm getting too old, but I have to always tune into TikTok and so often so I can stay on par with the much younger folks, you know?
Did I hear that? Let me read a couple of texts. Good day, Pearly. The PLP said, don't politicize murder. They politicized murder to the world some years ago. They ain't straightforward. Wait until they lose the election. You will see. Next is a good day, Pearly. Are you the gentleman that makes podcasts on on TikTok? Yeah, I did a couple of podcasts. Real talk, I call it. And then I got this thing I like old school music, so I put on my little dark shades and I sing Kiss and Say Goodbye and all them other songs. Hey, I got to keep up with the young folks. The crew I work with, all under 40. Most of them under 30. So I got to keep up with them and be able to, you know some of the talks, and that's how I learn. The New Day government has become a daily nightmare for the Bahamian people, and they can't seem to be getting anything right, other than ensuring the details of the next plane ticket is correct. Whoa. This one give me. Great show as usual. Is Naughty missing work because he caught the 333 in the day Texas today, boy, I tell you. No, I do Thursdays every week now for the last 3-4 months. So Naughty says that I've been on him at 5 o'clock. It's only fair that I get my own shot. So Naughty is the one that got me where I am today. So I'm very indebted to him, and I'm very happy that he's given me the courage and the strength and the belief in me to let me have Thursdays alone. Good show as usual, Pearly. Let's get straight to the meat of the situation. Ask your guests why the young people kill it and so high-tempered. Guess you heard that. I'll let you comment on that in a second, Xavier. And also ask, or two, why the young people have behavior problems and don't say no daddy in the home. Great show as usual. I never used TikTok before. Question, could I find the KFC recipe on TikTok? You know what? I saw something on TikTok saying the secret recipe of KFC there. Just pull it up. Just go on TikTok and say, put KFC recipe and see what happens. Pearly, in my view, I think we are operating the extremes with extremes. That is, we have students who are at the top doing the best students all over the history. All A's, 14 BGCSEs at one sitting, and then students who are engaging in the worst. Murders at school, engagement in gangs, etc. The number of students, young people in the middle, we will form the base of the middle class, which is used as one of the markets for a healthy society. Is decreasing and being lost to the worst category. This is a huge issue. Caller, you on the air. What you got to say? We can comment on that in a minute, Xavier and Anna. Let's hear the caller to say. Caller, you on the air.
Excellent show, Pearly.
Thank you.
Yeah, I am learning from these young people. I understand that the gentleman said that the young people today feel disconnected. Pearly, that's a serious, serious statement to make, you know.
Well, he's young. He's not 30 yet.
But boy, I mean, but at least by now should be feeling connected. But I guess he's talking about generally, right?
Yeah.
And then the young lady says that this sense of independence before the lifestyle, apparently, this introduction some of us may have been to certain lifestyles, and we got to pull back, got to become a minimalist to some degree because things ain't like it used to be. I don't know, Pearly, what you think?
Well, I don't know if they mean the lifestyle in terms of living an exaggerated life or exuberant spending and all that. I think she's talking about the lifestyle that they used to being able to go to the movies, they've been able to go to the fish fry, and they want to be able to afford those things on their own, not having to rely on a boyfriend, a married man, or a girlfriend, or another friend to do that for them. They want to be able to go to work, make their money, and enjoy their life.
Okay, well, Pearly, I'm pretty sure if you believe in prophecy, you would go back to a piece of scripture that talk about sin being remembered, you know, the sins of the...
The father falls on the children, stuff like that.
And also from the leaders, too.
Uh-huh.
So could it be, when you look at the contrast of the past 40 years, we've probably been getting or inheriting the sins of the persons we elected? And that should be a sign to tell you how sinful they really are.
Hey, Pearly,
have a good day.
You set me up, you know. You have a good day, brother. He like do this to me, though. But what do you think about the call out to say, Hannah?
I understand exactly what he's saying, and especially when you look at successive administrations who and what they've done, and honestly and truly, the decisions that they are making today further down the line, young persons and generations after me will have to pay for those decisions that they are making today. And I think that's why we need more young people to be at the decision-making table. Even if they're not elected into the House of Assembly or appointed to the Senate, they need to be sitting on government boards or corporations or have some form of input into the country that they that these persons who are inside the chair now will leave to them and the generations that follow.
Okay. They said, hold on. Great shows. Ask your young guests where the young people get the lust for guns from people who just love guns. Great shows usually ask your female guests, how come women or girls like bad men? Because for millions of years, girls and women gravitate to aggressive men or women. Is that true? I think the young girls in the Bahamas like to be with bad boys.
Personally, I cannot speak for all women, but what I can say is that there, in some households, there is an absence of a father figure. So you have some young women out there, not to generalize, you have some young women out there who gravitate to men who can provide and can protect them. And you also have some mothers out there who are doing the best that they can, but some mothers who weren't mothered properly as well. So that might be an issue. I mean, I have a phenomenal mother.
Okay.
I have a phenomenal mother and I love her so much. But yes, that is an issue.
Xavier, what do you think? You think girls in the, and I just sticking to the Bahamas, gravitate to bad boys or tough men? I used to think, in my day, I used to think the girls like men in uniform. But I think now, do you think girls are gravitating to bad boys?
Well, girl, I don't even know how to answer that. because sometimes I see some women who I look at and I'm like, these are beautiful young ladies and young women that have so much ahead of them. And you see the young men that they are gravitating to or they are with.
Uh-huh.
I'm trying to figure out, what do they see? What do you see in this person that can't obviously upkeep his appearance or doesn't look like the type of young man you know your mother would like for you to bring home. What do you see in these young men? And that's a question that I can't even answer because I've been trying to figure that out for the past 20-something years now.
Well, you ain't by yourself. But let me ask you this way then. Mm-hmm. If you decide to date, I don't even know if you're dating, but if you decide to date, what would you look for in a young man? What would Hannah look for in a young man?
Boyer.
And don't have any money.
Pearly? Oh, Pearly. Well, let me go a little scriptural. You know they say you gotta be equally yoked, uh-huh. Right? So sometimes you look for someone who is...
Call, I come to you in a second.
At your level or someone above. Because for me, I would aspire to be with someone who I can learn from. Who, when I'm learning from them, they don't, belittle me. Someone who respects me, respects my goals, and vice versa. Because once you respect me, I respect you as well. So that's one thing without delving into the other,
Okay.
Materialistic things.
let's take our first quick break. And we can come back, we can continue this conversation a little more. Xavier, thank you for being here. Don't go nowhere. Hannah, thank you for being here. Don't go nowhere. We take a quick break. We'll be right back. This is Pearly talking here. It's Thursdays on Guardian Radio. This is 96.9 FM. See you in a minute.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is now City of Hope, creating one of the leading cancer care and research networks from coast to coast, providing more of what you need. More locations means more care closer to home. More specialists means more expertise. More research means more breakthroughs. More advancements means more treatment options. And more options means more hope. Learn more at cancercenter.com.
Just because they were cheap, Keisha bought things that she really didn't want. Hungry for deals? Let KFC satisfy your cravings before you do something crazy. Get the new Kentucky Crunch Sandwich with a juicy KFC chicken filet, fresh lettuce, and the perfect amount of mayo topped with a fluffy sesame seed bun for just $5.75. Order your new favorite sandwich online with Messenger or WhatsApp Hi to 557-3663 to start your KFC order today. KFC knows value. It's finger-licking good.
Foreign Currency brings you the African Giant, live in concert, Burna Boy! Burna Boy performing live Saturday, February 17th, taking place at Clifford Bar with Burna Boy performing live. Also performing Rich Homie Quan, 38 Afri, Joe Capone, Back Civelli, Rati Pinder, Bloody, Fat Shot, Puzzle, Judah the Lion, and Jay Shepherd. Hosted by Natural Empress, Rika C, Pencil, and Aaron Ray. Music by the country's top DJs, Overdose, DJ Tech, DJ Hennessy, DJ Mad Bull, AJ Unruly, DJ Melody, Spinning the Gate 2024. Saturday, February 17th at Clifford Park with Burna Boy. Get tickets now. The name of the game is to be on the scene.
And we're back. Talking here, it's Thursday with Pearlie in the house. I've got Hannah with me and Xavier on the Zoom call. I'm going to read this text, and Xavier, I want you to comment on these texts. Ask your guests if for some reason women stop liking bad man will actually reverse the crime problem. Great show as usual. I think if women were not so tingsy, we could bring the thief in Nassau to a minimum. So I guess what that call is trying to say is because so many girls like these bad boys got to do things to maintain this girl. So they're saying that reverse. You think that makes sense or that's just craziness?
I mean, if people have their taste in what they want to have their taste in, right? But the reality is, if you see, and we've seen this in the past, uh-huh, when you see fashion changes, you see people, they start to change their fashion, obviously. So, okay, like, you see guys who were probably wearing the most baggy clothes or so forth. They now wear short pants and button-down shirt and boat-bound shoes.
Okay.
Because they realize that is something that women started to be attracted to.
I gotcha.
So if there were more women saying, man, I want a nice-looking young man or a young man who looks a particular way, or uh-huh, I don't want to deal with no rough-looking person, maybe the guys may start to change their life around.
So Xavier, you're telling me I need to get short pants and boatman shoes?
Well, listen to me. Put on some short pants and boatman shoes.
Uh-huh.
And your haircut, you may be a suitable bachelor.
Caller, you on the air. Are you there?
Hey.
Caller, what you saying?
Yeah, I just like to echo the sentiment with the young man just said.
Uh-huh.
Women have more power than they know.
Okay.
Like, even with anything else, if they require marriage before having kids, men will start there'll be more married women.
Okay.
If women require men to not be bad boys and get educated, and if all women stand as a whole on that, you'll see more men going to school. And there's nothing new under the sun. Lastly, I would like to say that there's nothing that's changed. Women like bad boys from back in the day. Women liking bad boys at the middle, they like bad boys now. And what happens is when they're younger, they're not interested in the studious guy, whatever. They look into the guy who's popular. So when they get hurt a couple of times, have a couple of children, not all women, but generally, they mature out of that. And then they want a good guy. And lastly, my last point, uh-huh, as it relates to having more young people in leadership positions, the only thing I'm concerned about is, a lot of the schools are super liberal. And when you have super liberal and you have a balance between conservative and liberal,
uh-huh,
what you start to echo in or bring into the fore is what they have in the United States, this super woke, super they, them, her pronouns, and they try to appease everybody. It's so emotional.
Okay.
That's what I'm more concerned about when you have a lot of young persons there who are been going to school. And most of the schools are super liberal now. You can't have a dissenting voice in most schools. And a lot of, when they go to school, they tend to come back with their degrees and thinking they know more than everybody else.
So that's millennials in general.
Yeah, but that's the only thing I'm concerned about when you have if you have young people, they're going to bring back what they learned from abroad and try to superimpose it on everybody else. But I'll hang up on this stuff.
Xavier, Hannah, let me ask you. Xavier, I know you deal with a lot of tourists. Hannah, I know you're a UB student right now. Are we finding our young people are now becoming super liberal and this they and not he and she, but they and them and these nouns and pronouns they're trying to use? Is that where we see our young people going today, Xavier?
Well, yeah. The reality is we live in a global society. And in this global society, you have young people who are going off into the U.S. and Canada, and they're being matriculated into those cultures, and they're seeing how liberal those cultures are, and they're coming back home. And not only that, like we talked about social media, you're seeing on social media where people are very liberal about their beliefs and how they want to portray themselves. And so young people in this country are picking up as well, and they feel like they have the obligation, they have the right to be have those freedoms as well. So that's what's happening.
Okay. Don't go nowhere, caller. Coming to you right now. You know, let me ask this question. I'm seeing a lot more. I tried to, because we're on radio, I can't ask it the way I really want to ask it. Particularly on TikTok, a lot more women are showing more parts of their body. They're wearing less clothes. They're wearing these tight, pum-pum shorts, or they're not wearing any clothes and really becoming what I call exhibitionists. Is that's what we young people about now, or that's just a single few? Anna?
I'd say that's a single few, because personally, I mean, I wear shorts on the beach or if it's extremely hot, but you wouldn't see me on social media exposing various parts of my body. So I'd just say that's a select few. I do see that you have certain social media handles and apps that do cater to those things where persons benefit financially from exposing themselves like that. So, and like the caller said, that there are guys who the girls love the bad boys yesterday, today, and forever, but you also have the men who love those type of women yesterday, today, and forever as well.
Mm.
So, I mean,
I got a question to ask you, Hannah. Let me take this caller, and I got to, yes, I was waiting. You sent me to somewhere. I got to ask you this question. Caller, let's, what you saying, caller?
To you and your guests.
Hey, what's happening, brother?
Wonderful. This is the GNN. You got some solid young guests there.
Yeah. That's all I was hanging with, right, is good young people.
Yeah, they're basically right on point. But when it comes to bad boys, I wouldn't categorize all aggressive men as bad boys, mm-hmm. because I was aggressive. I was never a bad boy.
Okay.
And a lot of women that I attracted, even though I may not have had the facial recognition, I was very aggressive, a kind of properly built guy. And women used to come up to me and tell me, I like you because you're aggressive.
Okay.
I like you because you build good, you look good.
Uh-huh.
You see, so it's more for women as a protectionist thing. They want a man that's gonna, they feel that it's going to protect them.
Okay.
And then they like a man, they feel that when it's time to hit back, that man is going to hit back. That's more of it. When it comes to their body, the women, I mean, I know we got the trait she said of women, but it's almost, I don't know how to say this, pretty like you say.
We on the radio.
It's in them to attract the opposite sex.
Yes.
Now, how they go about doing it, that I guess that's their choice. Because I see some women who don't wear nothing, but you're like, here you go, come over there. And I see some women who cover their bodies, but there is still the air of a sexuality about their
the mystery
that attracts men.
The mystery, yeah.
So it depends on what they want to do. Thanks for taking the call.
Thanks for calling, brother. Thanks for calling. You got another call on the line? Do we call you on the air? What you saying?
good.
What's happening?
I'm trying to stay out of it. I always, but you were bringing all these nice topics or whatever, and this perfect today or whatever. Now, like, I do speak to young people.
Uh-huh.
And my nephew told me the other day, he said, he blamed us because meaning me and my other siblings, because they don't have, they have a disconnect from their family. Like, they, like I remember, like I told you the other day, I remember Grammy used to put us in a car on Sunday and took us out Adelaide so we could play with our cousins.
Yes.
And on summertime, we used to go to TNC and camp on Gladstone Road, where you go camping and all that.
Yeah.
And you go, or you go to 8 Mile Rock or Zuma and hang with your other family. So you get to know your family.
Yes.
What they saying is they blame us because they don't know who their family is. I talked to a young man the other day, and I said, "Well, where your Grammy from?" He looked like he was lost. Like, he don't know that.
I've had a lot of that. Yeah, I see a lot of that happening. I do the same.
Yeah, you don't know. I said, but you know, if you find out where your Grammy from, that means you have commonage in the island, like, and you don't know, like, you understand, like, you got some property down there.
Uh-huh.
You see what I'm saying? So. Even the young yesterday, they sound like very intelligent, brilliant people.
Yeah, these college kids. These good people.
Right. And too. Now, they ain't like, we asking them about stuff that I'm sure they don't have no idea about. I mean, I can't say that. I don't know. I can't speak to it because I know my children wouldn't know about it. Like what goes on in the inner city. And although they might know one or two of the people there, but they don't know what's going on down there. And to a lot of times, like, and we just had this discussion earlier today. But, I always remember this, even when I was young. You better don't play at me because my boyfriend's crazy. you remember that? Like, you remember that? Like, you better watch for my boyfriend or they're crazy, but don't say nothing. Like,
yes, one girl said that, but me and the fella say, him ain't crazy. He may be funny, but he ain't crazy.
Yeah, but then that too. So that means they'll push. But you know what I always tell my daughter?
Uh-huh.
I say, look here, this is how it is. If I were you, you need to check whoever was down. If he put his hand on you or he be inappropriate to you, then I'll step up.
Yeah.
But I ain't going to go, the man look at you or you understand? Like, you're supposed to go to jail because somebody just looking at you.
Yeah.
Or,
uh-huh.
Or you and the club being fresh up with him now. You understand? Or you and his girlfriend getting a fight. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, I understand. I understand.
Yeah, it's not about some gang war all the time, and it's about this one was messing with this one. And you understand?
I understand.
Yeah, so, like I say, now we also have to pay attention to what the problem is. The problem is that, okay, yeah, this is a good conversation. the hormones in a woman.
Easy now. Don't get expert-y on me now, but go ahead.
No, but I mean, that's what I was taught. Let me put it like
this. Okay.
Because from caveman time, right?
Uh-huh.
If the woman naturally attracted to her in the animal kingdom, they attracted to, they want their offspring to be outside and safe.
Yeah.
Be able to survive.
They go after the strongest of the herd.
There
yes.
you go.
I got you.
You see, like the gentleman said, just now, his attributes, is
built, yeah, it's built and everything, yeah, body, yeah.
Sometimes that's exactly. So, and you have a lot of other kids, like, they don't have that. Like somebody that said that they don't have the father in the family.
Yeah,
I moved from Atlanta a while ago, and my kids, but I in their life all the time. They say, you got it, they're scared to tell me certain things because they know how I am.
Yeah, and now you go,
You see what I'm saying? So you don't even have to be in the house. You have to be in their life.
Yes.
You understand? Like,
yes.
So,
be in their life.
I understand everything that you are saying, and that's perfect because here you have some intelligent young people telling you, like, almost the same thing that the inner children, you know, the girls who ride in the bus and he ain't get no lunch money, and the bus driver pass up full, and, you know, she ain't always on the bus. She ain't even got bus fee.
Yep.
So, you understand? Like, so... Who ain't report her? He ain't come to school all week. And you understand?
I got you.
I can shut up before I get to school.
yeah, let's do that.
All right. All have a good day.
Bro. But, you know, he touched on it all, but the body and thing. I remember when I was young, this young girl used to come to church. I only come to church so I could sit behind you and see your broad shoulders. So they come in. I see why they did that. Call you on the air.
Hey, Brady.
Hey, what's up?
I'm to your guest.
Guest.
Good afternoon.
You know, I love those young folks, especially that young lady. Let me tell you, keep up your morals, keep up your standards, and you don't drop them for nobody. You keep it up. And the way, like you said, you will never, you'll go on the beach and wear short, but you will never go exposing yourself, you know, because the Bible said precious things are covered. Gold, silver, all those things are covered. And so you continue to take that stand. And the general being on before.
He's still there.
Okay, no, not him. My son, who called in.
Okay.
Talking about the morals and, you know, they go away and they come back all rough with values. So do you want them in leadership position? That's what you got to look at.
Amen.
Standards that we grew up on from school time, from way back. And, you know, my daughter, I could trust her. Right now, my daughter knows my bank account numbers and everything.
Okay.
I have for daddy. Years.
He's a good daddy. So he's a good daddy.
And never, a penny never was moved.
Yes.
Because we taught, my wife and I taught them, and the way that she dressed, because the mother dressed appropriately.
Yes.
And so when they see the mother dressing appropriately, they can follow suit.
Yes.
And like David said, son, give me that heart and let that eyes observe my ways.
Yes.
And someone said, godliness is more caught than taught.
Yes.
So that's what you got to be careful with the young people.
I agree.
I have no problem with them getting promoted. But your standards and your values have to be high.
Hey, listen to me. Me and my ex-wife can't live together. But I always tell people I have no regrets in the three children I had with her because she was a good example for my kids, particularly for my daughter.
Uh-huh.
And she's raised them. And one day, she called me and says, I just want to tell you this. I came to school to pick up your daughter from the dance. And as I sat here, I watched all these girls walk on the dance who had their shirt tie up around their stomach, who pulled their dress a little shorter, who was trying to sexy themselves. She said, but your daughter walked out of this dance the same way she walked out of your house morning, dressed properly.
Thank you.
And that was a really good feeling to hear. And, you know, it means that Ava was doing a good job and Pearly was doing a good job in raising their daughter. Thank you for calling. Go ahead.
You know, my daughter, one time someone said, boy, Mr. Starr, your daughter, she's very manly. I mean, from school time, even up today, a couple of days, you know, say, boy, your daughter on the job, she is very highly motivated and everything. And I praise God for my wife and I.
Amen.
We live that life. We live that. And I was the one at an early age led my son and my daughter to the Lord.
Amen. Yes. Amen. Thank you for calling.
Thank you, caller, for the words of encouragement.
Super. Got another call on the line? Caller, you on the air. How you doing? Oh, you give up on me? How you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Hey, baby, what's up?
I'm wonderful.
Super.
Wonderful.
How can I help you today?
Listen, I'm listening to the gentleman talking, and I quite agree with him, you know, because I have a daughter.
Okay.
She's 18.
Okay.
Right? And she is yet to have one choice of a boyfriend.
Okay.
Like she said, when she went to school, studying what she went to school for.
Okay.
You understand me?
Boys and books don't mix.
No. I tried to get her to dress more
younger,
feminine.
More younger.
But she feels like people will look at her shape. When she put on her uniform shirt, which is a button-down shirt, she wears a T-shirt, not a singlet. She don't wear the female singlet home in the house at night. She wears a T-shirt backwards under her shirt because she don't want her cleavage to show.
I got you.
You know, she dressed kind of like me.
Okay.
You understand me? You have to, like gentlemen, so you have to instill certain things in your children. The Bible says, train up a child in the way they should go, and then they will not depart from it.
Amen, amen.
If you go around some of these primary schools to see the way these mothers are dressed, some of the children get into fights over it. Because why? The mother comes with so much things exposed, the other children laughing, teasing, and pointing.
Yeah.
So the next day, you have a big fight in the school.
Yeah.
You don't have no shame and no care and no love for yourself. The least you could do is have some respect for how your child would feel when other children see you dress a certain way.
Amen.
You know, we have to live this thing.
Amen. Thank you. Thanks for calling. Got another call on the air? Caller, you there?
Lee, how are you?
Well, thanks for your patience. What's happening?
Yes, man. I also want to join in. I salute you, brother.
Thank you.
Listen to me. I know time is just about gone. I salute you. And you can't give this up, and you cannot make this. And also the young lady. And there's also a young man, eh?
Yes, Xavier. You still there, Xavier?
Yeah, right.
They still there, right?
Yeah, they're still there,
yes,
yeah.
Sir.
Listen to me. Whatever positive that you could suck up from Mr. Poirley, I suspect that's your father, right?
Oh, no, that's not my daughter, no.
Okay.
Well, anyway, just like a daughter to me, though.
Okay, whatever you can suck up. I don't know if Poirley is older than me.
I'm born in 62.
Oh, you're a young boy. You're a baby. And you're supposed to say no, sir, to me now
yes,
that
sir.
I know your father.
Yes, sir.
You're supposed to say no, sir, and yes, sir.
Yes,
and
sir.
Also, naughty.
Yes.
But let me say.
And naughty younger than me.
The show that you raised yesterday.
Uh-huh. On family.
I know some other callers reading and time is going.
Uh-huh.
That was so important. I listened to it last night again.
Thank you.
But you did not get much response. Pearly, I am convinced,
uh-huh,
wholeheartedly, this is a conspiracy. And let me tell you where this conspiracy from. This is coming from liberal-minded leaders and many, many, many effeminate pastors.
Okay.
And it's a matter of to control. And they are trying to effeminize the home, the school, all the public places. They has been effeminized. And politicians have a lot to do with it. So once they can get the man out of place,
uh-huh,
this is why these boys are so angry. We could develop a poorly socialized society. Now, they wake up the lion in the man,
uh-huh,
rather than cultivating the king. Now we cannot get the lion back to sleep. This is by design, and I will not change my belief.
I hear you, my brother. I believe
you. Have a wonderful
evening. Thank you so much for calling.
And the stage is set. Really, open your eyes. The stage is set for alternative lifestyle in this country in the Bahamas. But God forbid.
The devil is a liar.
The stage is set because
the devil is a liar.
You have persons in wolf and sheep clothing. This is why they're promoting gender equality, so they could effeminize persons like myself and you. But we can be wrong here for a long time.
Amen, I say. Thank you for calling, my brother. Read a couple of these texts. Pearly the Sparky, I guess by now you realize that Aaron Green has me banned of all Guardian shows for a personal reason. But I can text you to say that at 73 years, I'm afraid to leave my home in New Providence after 5 p.m. in the evening. Sparky, a lot of people are afraid. And I'm going to get to find out what is what. These seeds of the devil, just like other people thinks, and fast money, nothing to do with them women being tingsy. Okay. And then we realize that the PLP is the genesis of our current problems. We wouldn't get any better. They are right in the midst, pointing fingers and blaming others for what they created. Our modern deterioration started around the 70s and the 80s. And our great show, ask your guests how safe they feel in Nassau, and if election was called today, who would they vote for and why? I was trying to stay from this political thing, you know. And I can don't answer that question. I can let you answer at the end of the show. And I can tell you why I didn't want them to talk about that. Great show as usual, Pearly. Now you have me want to go on the talk TikTok and let me miss that, Pearly. You wrong for that. Iron sharpening iron. Pearly, so we onto something. The women dictates the emotions and social environment, maybe. Pearly, ask your guests if they think the mother and father are buddy-buddy and friends with them, affected them, or will affect them in a negative way. Because these friends are friendly with the kids. Your mommy wasn't your friend, right? Your mommy, your mommy was strict on you. Xavier, yours too, right?
My mommy used to tell me, I am not your friend.
Okay, Xavier, your mommy too, right?
If my mother threatened to come to my school, I said, no, mommy, don't come. Please.
But, you know, there are a lot of parents who want to be friends with their kids. Mm-hmm. And while I don't believe in beating my kids, and I didn't beat my kids, I thought this is my Pearly's opinion. I think if you spank a child, or spank a young person, spank a child, that pain go away after about 15 minutes, half hour, so that pain gone away. So what I did was we had something called timeout, and we took away their pleasures. They won't go to a party. No, you ain't at no party this weekend because you was rude all week. Then they can't go back to school and talk about the parties to their friends. I think that hurts more than a spanking. If they can't play their PlayStation or their Xbox, I think that hurts more than a spanking. So that's the way I looked at it. Now let me throw this curveball at you, Hannah. And I get, and Xavier, I want you to answer too. We talked about young women liking bad boys. And you said, you or callers said, think we are trendy people. We go with the trend. Mm-hmm. Okay? Somebody said the other day, the young girls don't want bad boys no more. They want gray hair man. They want older guys. They want that sugar daddy. Really? Right?
Pearly?
Is that true? Xavier, let me let Xavier answer that for you. Xavier, what do you think about
girls?
That?
Uh-huh. I'm walking on needles right now. I can say this. Some, S-O-M-E, some.
Okay.
Some young women are looking for daddy in the wrong place.
Okay.
That's all I say.
Okay.
And I see, and then and I'll say this as well. I know there are some people that are attracted to older men.
Uh-huh.
For whatever reason, and I've seen in many cases, these young women that grew up with a father, a loving father in their home, and so forth. But for some odd reason, they are still attracted to your older men. That may be because they realize how a man of their father's stature or something of that sort had treated their mother, has been a good man in their life, and so... I guess that's what they are attracted to.
So it's not the material thing. It's more about the security or the protection per se.
More than likely.
Maybe. And you know, I've heard young ladies say, "I don't want a little boy. No little boy could do nothing for me. No person around my age could do something for me."
Uh-huh.
And that's fine. That's their preference. But some SOME, some are looking for daddy in the wrong places.
I got you. And full disclosure here: when I got divorced, I dated a younger girl. A younger woman. And I got a lot of flack for it and saying, oh, she only wants your money. So I told her, she said, let me ask you one question. What money you got?
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Lord.
And I was like, okay. So and so it was like, hey, it's about the companionship, the friendship, the what you can teach me, what you can guide me, because these young boys today ain't focus. Is that true? Are the young men today not focus? This is your question, Hannah. Question? Yeah, this is your question.
When in my younger 20s, I would have said that a lot of young men really weren't focused. Actually, I wrote my BGCSE paper on how the Bohemian dream changed from being a lawyer, being a doctor, having some form of career path to now not downplaying anyone's professions, but working inside the hotel or the tourism industry, buying a Honda and renting an apartment. And I actually got an A in that BGCSE.
Really?
Yes. But what I can say now is I see a lot of young men are now striving to become successful and to become career-driven entrepreneurs and stuff like that. But I'm actually proud to see the amount of young men who are actually in leadership positions inside their schools, being head boys or being prefects, being head of extracurricular organizations. And even the amount of young men who are joining or entering the University of Bahamas, and even if they're not interested inside UB, going to BTVI, going to BAMSI. So back then, I would say that they're not focused. But I feel as if the young men nowadays, they are gaining some form of focus.
Okay. Caller, you on the air? What you got to say? Are you there, caller? Uh-huh. You got 30 seconds. I just realized the time.
Yeah, you got me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, man, hey, a lot of these girls, some of y'all, the younger girls, some dudes, they do want sugar daddy. They ain't looking for no daddy. Because they ain't really missing out on no daddy love, you know.
Okay.
They into this money now, this lashes and nails and this Remy and all that now.
I gotcha.
So the older guys, some can put the money out faster than the young guys.
Okay.
They take the older guy money and then spoil the young guys. Some up.
I gotcha. That's dangerous. That's very dangerous. Eh?
They on a tender. A lot of these young girls are on tender.
On Tinder.
For sugar daddy.
You mean the Tinder app?
Behemoth woman on tender.
Okay. I need to go on that
one
look.
One day you're trying to scroll on it, you might end up seeing the wrong person you don't want to see. I keep ghosts on it.
I know you ain't gonna see me, but I can look.
No, I say you, but I understand.
Okay.
You see someone, hey?
You peep ghosts.
You otherwise see them nice and holy and this and that. Uh-huh. What are they looking for? They're looking for sugar daddy, looking for someone to play for the plane ticket. And a lot of them is those. They catch a flight over and do the dirty over in the States.
I gotcha. So some, not all, just some. Okay.
Boy.
All right.
Half of them.
Okay.
All right.
Thanks for calling. Xavier, you got to say, and then Hannah will close out. What you got to say, Xavier?
So, girl, I just wanted to add on to what Hannah said. And like she said, there are young people, like young men that are doing so much. If you realize right now, you have a lot of young entrepreneurs. There are a lot of young men that are striving to be entrepreneurs. And various things. Some people are into the flipping of cars. They buying cars, they're selling cars, making money from that.
Okay.
However, I think, and then all obviously some people are into their trade.
Uh-huh.
They're into being retailers and uh-huh. selling of electronics or whatever uh-huh. it is. I think what we have to do, and we have agencies like the SBDC and Access Accelerator and uh-huh. Programs in the Ministry of Youth and so forth, that we need to ensure that we hone these young men and mm-hmm. make sure show them the correct way.
Thank you.
Of being business owners.
Thank you.
And so forth.
Okay. Thank you very much. Xavier, Hannah, thank you so much for joining me today. To answer the caller's question, Xavier is the president of the Torchbearers Youth Association, and Hannah is a member of the Torchbearers Youth Association. So I think that'll answer your question and how they intend to vote in the next election. But I didn't want this to be a political conversation. I wanted to just be two young people having a conversation. That's why I didn't talk about their positions and what role they play. I just wanted it to be a fair conversation. So Xavier, thank you for joining me. I hope to get you back one time so then when we can talk politics. And Hannah, thank you for joining me. I hope to get you back one time so we can talk politics. But today was just about young people.
Yes, thank you so much for having me, Pearlie.
Awesome.
Thank you so
it's
much.
It's a pleasure.
Great. This has been Pearlie. This is Talking Heads Thursdays. Pearlie on Guardian Ready 96.9. We go to take our break, go to the news. And when we come back, we can talk some sports. I had a defensive coordinator from the Cowboys gone somewhere. We'll talk about that. Dan Quinn is the new head coach of the Washington Commanders. This is Pearlie. We'll be back right after the news. Thank you ever so much for all the calls and the texts. It's been a great show.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Play with Island Games.
We making dreams come true.
Play with Island Games.
We paying more out to you. Don't mind the noise in the market. You get cash in your pocket.
Cause Island Games is spicy, and spicy is tradition.
So when you play
Island Games,
we putting Bahamian's voice guaranteed to pay.
Island Games.
We like them other jokers. We've been here from the start, from the bike to computer.
Island Games.
We can make your dreams come true.
We playing with Island Games.
Every day in a busy world, we have to do so much. Bank with CIBC and get that personal touch. Share your ambitions, let us help your dreams come true. At CIBC, we're at the heart of all we do. We're on your side, we're listening, we know the way you feel. CIBC, ambitions made real.
Just because they were on sale, Max bought things that he and his friend really didn't need. Hungry for deals? Let KFC satisfy your cravings before you do something crazy. Get a KFC 6-piece value deal with 6 pieces of juicy fried chicken, 3 orders of crispy fries, and 3 buttery biscuits, all for only $20. Order your new favorite deal online with Messenger or WhatsApp Hi to 557-3663 to start your KFC order today. Nobody does value like KFC, and it's finger-licking good.
John's Department Store January sale has begun, and you don't want to miss out on our greatest savings event of the year. 25% off all items, appliances included, except Timberland and Sperry brand items, which are 15% off. And don't forget our nursing, hospitality, and chef uniform store, John's Carewear, as well as our women's fashion store, John's Fast Fashion, which is also 25% off everything. Whatever your footwear and fashion needs, come into John's in Palmdale or Carmichael Road this January 27th through February 3rd to start the year off right. John's, we put fashion at your feet.
And good afternoon. Welcome back. Talking Heads Thursday with Pearlie in the house. Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Time to talk sports. How y'all doing out there?
Everything good? Let me, you know, when I first started doing this, I used to have to throw the numbers out hoping people call. I didn't even have to say the numbers and people call, but I can say them today. 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259, or 242-300-5720. And if you want to text me, powered by BTC, 422-4796. Now, before I get into sports thing, I did leave out one text I wanted to read. Good day, Pearly. Be in the same age brackets, but you could tell Juan and Carlton fix the Wi-Fi on the box. No, that's the government doing that. And that's not IRCA. That's something the government did. That was something started under the Minister administration. And that's something this government said they were doing. So if they don't maintain it, what do you think will happen? So you got to maintain it, check it out, make sure it's working and all that stuff. That was a deal the government made, I think, with Alive, if I'm correct. I could be wrong, but you don't quote me. So today in sports history, let's see what's happening. Let's see what's going on today in sports history. Brought to you by Naughty Johnny's. Today is Thursday. It's the first day of February in the year 2024. Today in sports history, in 1913, Jim Thorpe signed a contract to play baseball with the New York Baseball Giants. And they later moved to the San Francisco. In 1929, weightlifter Charles Regault of France achieved the first 400-pound clean and jerk as he lifted 402.5 pounds. 1962, the National League released its first 162-game schedule. Great year, 62. In 1968, Vince Lombardi resigned as the coach of the Green Bay Packers. In 1970, Terry Sawchuk got the last shutout of his career and set the career record of 103. In 1992, Barry Bonds signed the highest single-season contract. It was for $4.7 million. That right? That's a good fall. Maybe so. In 1992, Dennis Potvin, number 5, became the first number of the to be retired by the New York Islanders. In 1995, John Stockton of the Utah Jazz became the NBA career assist leader when he scored his 9,922nd assist to move past the great Irvin Magic Johnson. In 2015, Tom Brady of the New England Patriots set a Super Bowl record with 37 completions. Brady also increased his career Super Bowl touchdown passes to 13, setting a new record. The sports quote of the day, the difference between impossible and the possible lies in a man's determination. That's the great former Los Angeles Dodger coach who says, if you cut me now, I bleed Dodger blue, Tommy Lasorda. Yeah, I'm a Dodger fan. Y'all know that. So, let's see what's happening in the sports page. The BAISS, the BAAA trying to bridge the gap. Archer hoping for a resolution in short order. NFL Flag Bahamas sending 3 teams to Pro Bowl. RB Charlton received NCAA weekly honors. BAISS, B3As trying to bridge the gap. Archer hoping for a resolution in short order. It's kind of sad that we're not going to see the BAISS track and field championships. That's really kind of sad. It's so good to looking to see soccer in another one. But, you know, you do whatever you can do to stop us for a minute. That's fine. We got a call on the line? I just being facetious. Y'all leave me. I just being facetious. We got a call on the line, Mr. Producer? Call, are you there?
Thompson.
Hey, what's happening?
Everything good. This is Muff.
Hey, Muff, what you saying?
Yeah, so Dan Quinn, he was the offensive coordinator for Dallas.
The defensive coordinator for Dallas. Yeah, he used to be.
He gone to Washington.
He gone as the head coach of the Washington Commanders. Washington. Yes.
Well, if he go there coaching, like, God, Dallas played the last game. Washington ain't going nowhere. if he can't, I see the type of coaching, what he do with the defensive coordinator, Washington could still be with 6 games under 500.
I have a cousin, Eric, who went to Howard University in Washington, and he was a huge Redskin fan, so he just carried over to his Commanders.
Mm-hmm.
And he texts, and we have a chat with all the men in our family. We have because we're talking sports and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
He say, cuz, I ain't feeling this Dan Quinn signing. And my son is a big Atlanta Falcons fan, right? He said, brother got a history of losing. You know, he was the head coach when Atlanta had that big lead in the Super Bowl to Tom Brady and Lewis.
Lewis. So seven new head coach gets hired, right?
All teams now have their head coaches in place.
And the Seattle head coach is the youngest coach in the league.
I think at 39, if I remember correctly. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, well, Pearly, you and Naughty, they had Lakers playing Boston tonight.
Cut it, more cut it, because LeBron yeah, Naughty, well, LeBron Naughty, AD playing tonight.
Right, you see we had the break, that 7-game losing streak last night against the Kings.
I see that, yeah, I see that. Yeah, listen, I was going to, I didn't parlay, I was going to parlay because I win the night before. I was going to parlay last night, and I had y'all to lose, and for some reason, I didn't get to do it. I didn't get to do it, and I say, thank God I ain't put it because I had to
Yeah, that's true. Well, we can on a 7-game winning streak now because we got Washington tomorrow night.
So, I mean, so when I do my parlay tomorrow, I pick you all to win it.
Yeah, and then Saturday is the big test. So we got the Clippers on Saturday night at 6 o'clock. Paul George, them. That's the real, and Harden.
But the hurtful,
and Westbrook.
The hurtful thing, but this is the Lakers can be in a 3-game or 4-game losing streak because I know Boston can beat us tonight. And then we got the...
You're the Knicks
on Saturday.
Yeah, you got the Knicks on Saturday. But Saturday then the Clippers beat Boston the other night.
Clippers got a good team.
Yeah, they got a good team.
The Lakers win
7 straight or 6 or 8 straight.
Something like that, yeah.
Something like that.
The Clippers has a really good team. The Lakers got a decent offense. We just can't play defense. We just do not play defense.
We can't
stop the Kentucky Colonels or the Beck Cougars right now.
But you're playing a little bit of defense in that double overtime the other night.
That was the and guess what? The next day they come out and lay egg in defense. Pissing me right off. Listen, I can tell you this, Muff. I can't wait for baseball to start. Baseball start tomorrow. I stop watching basketball.
Yeah, okay. I know you and your dog just go. Yeah. But like I say, like that, it's the Florida Marlins. So I can be going in a little bit for that too.
We can look at making that move in September for that game in Miami. Me and Naughty can talk about it. We can see me. Let's do a team ride over there to go see the Dodgers beat up on the Marlins.
Watch them out now. I can make that trip too, man. All right, we can set it up.
All right, take care.
We still got to talk too because you know we got a big weekend coming up.
Let's plan something. Okay.
Yeah, we can plan off here. All right. Yes, boss.
You take time.
Manners and respect.
All right. That's the great Muff. One thing, Muff is give me a call now. That's good, cool, but he's a good sports minded dude. I mean, I can't blame him for the teams he's pulled for, but that's all right. He's a good brother. Burley, tell your choo-choo nation to stop the nonsense and line up to face the music. I quite understand what you mean by that. You need to clarify that a little bit. Burley, I actually guess if you think the mother and father are buddy-buddy, we talk about that. Great show as usual. The Clippers are actually the only authentic super team in NBA present date. You're just a Laker hater. That's all I can say. I actually think, I think even though the Bucks lost 2 in a row, I think the Bucks got a pretty good super team too with Damian Lillard and the Greek Freak. And Middleton, I think they got a pretty decent team. I think y'all surprised. Let me tell you the team to sleep on. And, you know, I told you this, but the Rams had a good run in the playoffs. Them Knicks starting to look good. Them Knicks starting to really play some good basketball. That move they made, they starting to look good. And I think they can embarrass my Lakers on Saturday. I think the Boston can embarrass tonight, too, because without AD, without AD and LeBron, them young fellas might play their butts off. So we'll see what happens there. We'll see how it goes. You got a call on the line, Mr. Producer. Carla, what you saying? You all right?
Everybody all is well?
Hey, my brother. I'm good. Thank God for life.
That's a good pick you say right there. That's my ghost pick right there to them Knicks.
Uh-huh.
And it's all because of that little point guard, boy.
Yeah. Knicks look good. Knicks look really good. My dad used to be a Knicks fan, so if my Lakers don't do well, I might just, not pull, but encourage the Knicks this season.
It's worse than the Cowboys, man.
Yeah, you like, yeah, they... Be nice, man. Be nice. Please be nice.
They always let you down, even when they make it.
Boy, listen. I get 17 championships to my Lakers. 17. And I saw most of them I saw myself.
I ready for LeBron to leave now so we can reboot, man.
But in the words of Naughty, we never wanted him there in the first place.
Exactly.
You know? So the quicker... Listen, he has an option here next year, and they say the management is not talking to him about it. I hope they never talk to him about it and say, listen, after the season, sayonara, let's take that $50 million we had to give him and spend it on some young players, and let's try rebuild this team.
Time for him to go, man. All our young players running ragged all over the whole league right now, man.
Yeah, all them fellas we had to be going trade away. Look at Brandon Ingram in the Pelicans. Boy.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah.
All right, buddy.
All right, brother. Thanks for calling. I appreciate that. Let me see what this text is saying. Great. Come on, phone. Open up. Says great. Great show as usual. Pretty. I make money every time Detroit play because you bet against Detroit. Detroit only got but four or five wins for the year. No, that's almost a safe bet. To go against Detroit. If I bet against Detroit, I bet on the money line, I bet on the spread. Because they they get beat bad. They be embarrassed. They play hard. They do play hard, but they really get beat kind of bad, you know? They get beat kind of bad, but that's fine. That's fine. So, Dan Quinn is now the head coach, and some things happen now. Some interesting things happening. I'm surprised that the Commanders went that route because most of the leagues are now going, they pass on Belichick. They gave him younger players. Younger coaches, these hotshot coaches who coming up with all these super type, super offensive and super defenses. Dan Quinn, Dallas Cowboys defense didn't look like much. They couldn't stop the run. And fellas figuring about Micah Parsons was the catalyst, and they ran at him and blocked him and just ran rough shot over Dallas. And when Dallas changed his defense, it started to play better, still going right back to what they were doing before. So, you know, I understand. See, that what the NBA has implemented is these fines that they give these teams. If you put in your players on the injured reserve, on the injured report, and in an accurate and timely manner prior to. So, the other day, the Sixers didn't play Embiid against Denver. And you remember some people talk about, I don't know if you remember, ESPN them teased them about that because Embiid never won, when they go to Denver, never won't play because he don't get embarrassed. But they were fined $75,000 for that. It may not sound like a lot of money to that team, but it's a record of how it looks that they were fined for that. Embiid is on the jeopardy of not being able to be qualified for the MVP of the league because if he misses four more games, that's him. You have to play a minimum of 65 games to be qualified for any kind of awards, for rookie of the year, for MVP of the league, for the scoring title, for anything. You have to be in that 65 games. So he has four games. He only can miss four games for the rest of the season. Four. And if he misses those four games for the rest of the season, any one of the four games, any time from now to the end of the season, then he's not eligible for MVP of the league. And they just give it right back to the Joker. That's what's going to happen. Watch. That's what's going to happen. So Dan Quinn is the new head coach of the Commanders. Let me give you a little background on him a little bit. Some of the other teams that he's played for, okay? So he's just the Dallas Cowboys defensive coordinator. So he's left Dallas to go to Washington. He's replacing Ron Rivera. I'm surprised that they didn't give it to Bieniemy. I don't know why. So I don't know what that means. I don't know. They really were trying to get. I really think that Quinn was to settle. I think they were really trying to get Ben Johnson from the Detroit Lions, and when he decided he was staying there, I think. And it's kind of surprising a lot of people because he's a hot shot. He got a great defense. He's got a hot shot defensive coordinator, and a lot of people thought he would have gotten the job, and really thought he was going to Washington. He turned him down to stay in Detroit. So Detroit must have given him, like Dallas did with Don, giving him head coach money. Because Detroit needs a lot of work. I mean, not a lot of work, but they're fast, a vast improving defense and a fast improving teams. I still think they're a year or two ahead as far as they got to the AFC Championship game. I think they're a year or two ahead. I look for great things for them next year, particularly with Johnson staying there, okay? He's with Atlanta. He was the head coach of Atlanta when he blew the lead. He blew the lead to the New England Patriots in the championships. I think they had must see a 20-something point lead. And he blew that. So I don't know. He was six years with Atlanta from 2015 to 2020. Had two trips to the postseason, including appearance in the Super Bowl 58. But they said they need this is the rationale they're putting behind it. And I'll read it to you. The Commanders badly need a head coach with a strong personality, leadership skills, and the ability to develop young talent. They say Quinn has been successful throughout the NFL coaching career and has more than earned a second chance to lead the team. If the Commanders can get even adequate play from the defense with Quinn steering the ship, it will make life much easier for the offense if they draft a quarterback with their top pick. They do need a quarterback. The kid tried his best to do some things, but they do need a quarterback. So that's going to be, I don't know. Lakers got the Celtics tonight, okay? No LeBron, no AD. You know what that means. Last time I said, I mean, the fellas, I'm surprised, but I can't see this beating Boston. If we beat Boston tonight, then Boston needs some work too, because I really think Boston's the best team in the NBA. That would be surprising to me if them Celtics lose to us tonight. I don't know. What are your views on Dan Quinn? Dan Quinn. I know Naughty happy. I think Naughty's pretty happy he's gone. I think Naughty was hoping that McCarthy would go the same time. But I think this would open the door to bring Vabrel as the defensive coordinator. Hopefully he'll give him that job. And so when McCarthy messes up with Dallas next year and they don't make the playoffs or get beat in the first round of playoffs again next year, then they slide him right in. That's a possibility. We got a call on the line, caller. Caller, what you saying?
Hey, Naughty.
No, that's a good-looking one. Pearly. Pearly. That's a good-looking one. Yeah, let's get that right. What's happening?
Well, you're saying it right. You all see, when you got them two head fellas out, you all ain't gonna stand a chance.
I know that. I haven't even watched that game.
Yeah.
I so wish baseball was on right now, but...
Yeah, now, you talk about LeBron and thing. LeBron still could come off a bench for a team, you know.
No, I'm not saying he can't. I just think that he hurt the Lakers. The Lakers won the bubble championship, and other than that, he gave the Lakers nothing.
Because Ingram was nothing. A good player.
Yeah.
I didn't like Ingram, and then in the hard, what's his name, Guzman?
Caruso.
Guzman can shoot that ball, bro.
Yeah, Guzman. And then
yeah,
Caruso.
Yeah, he was good.
Yeah, but he hasn't excelled since leaving the Lakers, so I'm not too worried. But it's the White Mamba that I'm more concerned about. I wish that we had never gotten rid of.
Yeah. And now on the football thing, now yeah, you mentioned, but Detroit.
Now, yeah,
if you got a 17-point lead, two things can't fail you one time.
Well, I don't know so much if it's the defense that failure or the play calling by the offense. Now, understand?
Yeah, they just go on.
No, Detroit went away from their game. Detroit just ran all over the 49ers in the first half. 42-yard run for a touchdown. Big run here. Big run. And then all of a sudden they only had maybe, if I'm correct, they only ran the ball, I think, 6 or 8 times in the second half. They tried to pass. When you start passing 3 and out, you stop the clock. You give the team the ball back, and you give the team an opportunity to keep your defense on the field too long, and your defense gets tired.
I watched that game, too. Man, I say, my goodness, and they let them come right back.
Campbell is a young coach. He made some mistakes, but guess what? I think he's going to learn from the mistakes. And if he's in that position next year, I think you'll see a different result with Detroit.
Yeah, because, like I say, they let the offense go on there and the defense. You know, that ain't cutting it. But so what do you think about the Dolphins?
Well, the Dolphins in trouble, and let me tell you why the Dolphins in trouble. The Dolphins got a $46 to $50 million cap hit. They over the salary cap.
What?
So that means that they got to cut... If cutting him that $17 million, they're gonna cut Xavier Howard. That's gonna be another $17 million, and they can probably end up cutting Armstead, which will be another $13 million just to get under the cap.
Yeah.
And then they have to restructure some contracts and everything like that. But so I don't see the Dolphins picking up no big name player this year. I think the Dolphins doing a lot of secondary players if they sign any free agents and really build through the draft, which to me may be a good thing. Because Dolphins have a lot of needs. We need offensive line help. We need we may lose Christian Wilkinson because Christian Wilkinson is going to want $15 to $20 million. I would much rather cut Xavier, cut Armstead, cut Igbar, cut the next one, and take that money and give that to Wilkinson because that's who we need on that the close as a defensive tackle next to Sola.
Yeah, but y'all got a good nucleus team now. I mean,
we got a good nucleus with Chubb coming back with Waddle, you know, Justin Fields. I'm not just kidding, Justin Fields.
Yeah.
With Holland and all them coming back, we got the nucleus of a decent name. Van Pelt, I hope we can sign him back. So it's you know, I believe that Chris Gradham had thought about this, know what they have up against them, and make the right moves.
Yeah.
But there's going to be some casualties on the Dolphins this year, and guess what? That's part of the game.
Oh yeah. All right then.
Okay, my brother.
Yeah.
You take care of yourself. Thanks for calling. I do appreciate that. Taxi here says. Pearly, Sack does not want this meet because the writing is on the wall. It's a pathetic and selfish the amount of red herring come to the track on the date schedule and collect your victory. Listen. That's all right. That's fine with me. There's another caller over the line? Caller, you there? No, sorry about that. That's me. Sorry, producer. Hey, Pearly, I'm glad the Cowboys got rid of Dan Quinn, just like the Dolphins got rid of Vic Fangio. Hey, I so happy about that too. I am so happy we got rid of that Fangio. I just want to know who we get. We wanted Ben Johnson from Detroit, but he's staying there. So there's Staley, and then there's the kid, the outside linebacker coach and the linebacker coach who they may promote. Either way, I'm happy. Let's take our first break. Caller, don't go nowhere. We'll talk to you in a minute. Don't go nowhere, caller. We can take our first break. When we come back, you're the first person up. This is Talking Heads Thursday with Pearly, Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Hey, I'll be right back.
Refined style with elegant taste, the fine threads is your place. If you want those slacks hemmed or just taking the waist, then fine threads is your place. If you want to look suave and debonair everywhere you go, like you're supposed to be in a video. Want to step out and look great? Then fine threads is your place. Refined style with elegant taste, then fine threads is your place. Is your place, is your place.
Struggling to repay your loan? Let us help you get back on track with payment terms that suits your financial situation and improve your credit score and credit report with the Bahamas Credit Bureau. Inquire about our restructured loans today. Call us at 356-7764.
Just because they were cheap, Keisha bought things that she really didn't want. Hungry for deals? Let KFC satisfy your cravings before you do something crazy. Get the new Kentucky Crunch Sandwich with a juicy KFC chicken filet, fresh lettuce, and the perfect amount of mayo topped with a fluffy sesame seed bun for just $5.75. Order your new favorite sandwich online with Messenger or WhatsApp Hi to 557-3663 to start your KFC order today. KFC knows value. It's finger-licking good.
And we're back. Talking Heads Thursday, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. It's on the back half now. Callie on the air, what you saying?
Some Dolphins, man.
What about my Dolphins?
The only way y'all go win? Tell you right now, y'all got to pull off one of them big trades. Using that same wide receiver y'all got, Tyreek Hill. Like what Dallas pull off back in the day.
And get who? You mean like?
I hope y'all get some good defensive players and some good offensive players for one man. You understand? Some good young players. That's the only way y'all could listen. All your money invested in that one player, you know.
And who, Tyreek?
Yeah, boy. And your quarterback.
No, man, we spend money.
Your quarterback sucks.
Why would you think my quarterback sucks?
Well, you know your quarterback sucks, man.
Why do you think that? Explain it to me, because that's just your saying. Tell me why.
Listen, you see that? We see that Brian, the 49er fan. You see that Brock Purdy? That's why I say he sucks. That's 2 years in the league. How much years your quarterback been in the league now?
This is my quarterback first full year in the league. He didn't play under Flores. Flores bench him for the whole season. Last year he was hurt. He only played 8 games or 9 games last year.
Mm-hmm.
This year he played his first full game. But guess what now? Brock Purdy had a healthy team. He had Kittle. He had McCaffrey. He had Debo. Mm-hmm. He had all his players. Two of the novice players. Waddle was hurt most of the season. Waddle came back and played us halfway here. Hill was playing hurt. We lost all our defense. We lost our offense. Our whole offensive line was hurt. If we had a healthy team and he performed the way you want to say, then I'd say I would say you're correct.
Well, y'all have been just like the Ravens. Ravens was healthy too. See what happened to them.
Yeah. So what? So you. Let me put you on the spot now. So you say the 49ers win it all?
Oh yeah, man.
Sound like you're a 49er fan.
Been too long, all day, every day.
JT's
and rice, buddy. JT's and rice.
Now we getting to what's going on here.
Once we have no injuries,
well, that's
Purdy don't get injured, we straight.
No, it ain't Purdy, you know. is Debo Samuel's place, y'all straight.
Yeah, man, Debo Samuel's open up the field, man.
Exactly.
They got to look out for him. They once he in motion, that's it.
Exactly. That's the
point.
That's
all eyes on him. That's it.
That's exactly.
Mm-hmm. All right, buddy.
All right, brother. Thanks for calling. I appreciate
that.
Bro.
All right.
That's too funny. That is too funny. So, Mr. Producer, what we got for our final 10 today? I didn't even know what we got for our final 10. You want to talk about Don come in a little bit? What you think? Producer, that's to tell me yes to everything. You know, if I tell the producer, jump on, he may say yes. Okay. He may say yes. Okay. You know something? I want to do something a little different. Since I'm a big Dolphin fan, and some people don't like me being a Dolphin fan, we can go to the Dolphin Today show. And we can talk about the Miami Dolphins mock draft. Players to watch, positions of need by the Dolphins this year. I like that one. We can do something different. Because Naughty doesn't like to do the herd and all them stuff. Let's do something a little different today. What you think, Krimi? That's fine? You good with that? Okay, let's see what this caller got to say then. Caller, what you saying?
Yeah, buddy, I just called back to tell you. I forget to tell you. So you see Doc Rivers 0-2, eh? So Dame Dollar couldn't do it against his old team last night, eh?
I think that was an emotional. I think that was heavily emotional.
Dame beat them, man.
No, I think that's more emotions than anything else, you know? And you got to understand, too.
Team position beat them.
Yeah, that's all right. Listen, they all any team can win on any given night. Any team can win on any given night.
And that's what I got in now, but that's what I'll show you. But I feel bad for Behemoth Boy, Andrew Aiden, boy. You mean you was with Phoenix with a playoff team. Now you down there with a team in 14th position. The basketball gods can't even help you all get in the play-in.
Yeah, but he played good last night, though.
You can end him early. I feel bad for him.
Yeah,
man.
But he played good last night, though. He played really well last night.
Yeah, he played good. That's what he played. Well, where Marcus Smart gone now?
I don't know. I need to find a way. I thought Marcus Smart was in Toronto. He's not in Portland.
Well, they must be, that's where he get traded to now because he was with John Morantem.
I got to find out where he is.
Yeah, with Memphis. I think he's with John Morantem. But in basketball, you know, basketball no more with John Morantem, boy. I miss all of my highlights, boy.
You like that,
boy? I go on.
Okay, brother. Texas says, the Lakers will do the Celtics in. That Lakers will finally trade LeBron to any team that want him. Is there a team that want him? Is it any truth that Sox celebrating no BAIS track and field meet? Are you scared of them coming? I ain't got nothing to do with it. See? All right. Let's call on the line. Let me explain this to y'all. The BAISS is made up of, I think, 14, if I'm correct, private schools, including St. Augustine's, Queens College, St. John's, St. Anne's, Prince Will, Temple Christian, Windsor, and a number of other schools. I can't remember all of them. I've talked Kingsway and some other schools. All right? They all unanimously, that means everybody, agreed to not having the BAISS track and field meet the week before, which is too close, according to most coaches. To most, some disagree. I got some of them disagree. Jason, I know you disagree. Said it's too close to the Carifta trials. And they want, and a lot of that coach, they don't want the athletes getting injured or whatever. Whether we agree or not, I have to go with the wisdom of the principals of all these schools. That they have enough sense to understand what it means not to have the BAIS as track and field championship. And we have to understand, see, somebody says, oh, we hurting the Bantam. Bantams got 5 more years to run. Oh, we hurting the seniors who have their last year. I understand that piece, and yes, I feel for that. But it's about the athletes. In my opinion, in Pearly's opinion, the BAISS track and field championships and the GSSSA track and field is who can win it. If it ain't about who can win it, then don't give no trophy or don't give no ribbons and just say participation. Callie on there, how you doing?
Marcus Smarty get hurt. I think he out for a month.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay. That's it? Well, see, I like them callers who's calling, give me a little help like that and just run away. So, Sock ain't scared of nobody because Sock got 30 out of 32 or 28 out of 30 championships. That says a lot, right? Plus, most of the Carifta team are made of a BAISS track and field athletes. Most of the Carifta team. And particularly from St. Augustine's and Queens College and some of them in other schools. But those two schools make up a big piece of the Carifta team. So if it's it's a national, that's not a national event. That's a private school event. A national event would be the National Track and Field High School Championship. That's a national event. And that ain't happening until after Carifta, I think. I could be wrong. Don't quote me. But you representing your country, you're representing the Bahamas at Charifta is very important. And if it means that we have to, and listen to me, I want to see every track meet. I want you to understand that. But I have to accept that. I have to accept that these athletes are paramount to the Charifta Championship in the Bahamas being able to challenge Jamaica come Charifta. If they can't do that, then why go? That's just my opinion now. I know some people and my good friend Jason, who I went to soccer with, are very concerned that we're not having this championship, and he's feeling for the athletes who will not be able to participate. And I feel for them too. Maybe they'll have it afterwards. But at this point, I think the Charifta team is the most important thing right now, representing the Bahamas. I would hate to lose an athlete who would run in the beer and can't make it the next week. And I could be wrong. So that's my view on it. I would like your view on it. Let me know what you think about it, because I know my good friend, he done around me. I waiting on a text from him right now to tell me. We'll see. But back to NFL. A lot of people don't feel good about Dan Quinn. Why are they going? A 60-something plus year old man. And I mean, I shouldn't say that because that's me too, right? So that's what I'm saying. But in terms of sports, in terms of that, a lot of these young bucks, the 30-somethings, the 40-something-year-olds, coordinators, who all they do is eat, sleep, and study football. And they study in a different way than we do, you know. We go on the field, we look at players, we see all that stuff, but then they do the same thing, but they do something different. They do analytics, a lot of computer software stuff, a lot of analyzing. So when they do it like that, it leaves, I don't know. I'm just lost for words on this one because I never thought Washington would bring Dan Quinn there. Like I never thought Atlanta would have signed Belichick. And the question was asked, is Belichick coaching days finished? Some people think he only wants to coach for the next 2 years to get them 15 wins to pass my Don Shula. This text really messed with me today. You know, he said, is there any truth to Sox celebrating beer and no BIS and fear because they scared of the comments? I feel the train was going to get derailed. You can duck out this lap. Listen, Sox ain't never scared. We red and we never scared. Y'all forget, y'all don't know what I'm saying. I hope you notice that several St. Augustine's athletes have already qualified for the Charifta team. We're the defending champs. Yeah, it might have been a battle. QC always can give you a battle. You know, scholarship. Always can be a battle. And then everybody coming at St. Augustine's. I remember in my day in school, they don't care if they win the race as long as they beat Sark. They could come seventh as long as Sark come eighth. They happy. It was more about beating St. Augustine's than winning the championships, you know. And I sure QC don't want to beat a depleted St. Augustine's. They won't beat a full squad so they get brag right. And vice versa. So when we get all this super concern and running on, but Sock ain't scared of nobody. Because there's one thing we can win is our track and field championship. We not win all the basketball or softball, but we can win that track and field championship. And now we challenge for the swimming championship too. Along with the best BGC SC results. So, you know, it is what it is. Well, we gotta start looking at these picks, eh? And then we get to the break. The break can be all about my Dolphins today. And I've been deliberate doing that. You know, I mean to do it. Let's hear with my Dolphins. So my Dolphin fans are there. Tune in and listen to some of the potential moves that the Dolphins may make. We need offensive line help. That may be out. And this is the first time the Dolphins had a number one pick in a little bit. We had number one. We got a number two. No third or fourth round pick. Because of that tampering foolishness with them fellas getting probably trying to get Brady over there. I don't know why. And that we can talk about that another time. Then we get fifth, sixth, and seventh pick. I think we get 2 6ths or 2 5ths. So we get 6 picks. 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, and another pick. Yeah, 6 picks. No third or fourth. So who do the Dolphins pick for the first pick? They're talking about maybe going with an offensive lineman or a defensive tackle. And if the Dolphins make their number one pick a defensive tackle, you could rest assured Christian Wilkinson gone. Because they ain't going to pay that money. It's all about business. I hate for him to lose. One of my favorite players, number 94. Love to see him play. But money. If you ain't got the money, you can't pay him. And he wants the money. He wants to be paid. I thought they made a mistake by not paying him last year. He might have got him for 12 to 15 million. Now it's 15 to 20 million because he had a great year. Career high in sacks. Career high in behind the scrimmage line tackles. Tackles for losses. Great, career high in tackles. He had a career year. So guess what? Pay me what you owe me. That's what's going to happen. That's exactly what's going to happen. And it's going to be hard to see. It's going to be hard to see him leave the Dolphins. But I've seen it happen so many times. I've seen it happen so many times. But we'll see. Now it's time to do the picks, eh? Let's see now. Who's playing tonight? I call my friend. I said, "Boy, I ain't messing with no parlay tonight. I don't like these games. I ain't feeling these games tonight. I ain't feeling these. So whatever I pick, I give you is what. That's how I feel about the pick. But I probably ain't betting today. So let's look at basketball. Let me get on more. We can do NBA and NCAA because I really get started getting NCAA right now. So the first game tonight is Indiana Pacers at the New York Knicks. Knicks playing great ball. Pacers playing some good basketball too now. That pickup is Siakam. That's a good pickup. They're playing some good ball. Is Haliburton back? He's game time decision, so he may play. Randall is out. Yeah, he hurt his shoulder for the Knicks. But the Knicks still playing good ball. That's why the spread is a little closer, but I can go with the Knicks and the money line. Grizzlies at Cavaliers. I'm going to go with the Cavaliers. Sixers at Utah. We'll go with Utah tonight. And the Lakers at Boston. No, Boston can eat them for breakfast. I want to go with the money line. That's it. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to have the Dolphins Dolphins Nation. They're going to talk a little bit about Miami picks. We get into the news. I'll see you next week. I'll be with Naughty tomorrow at 5 o'clock. Thank you so much. It's been a great day. We had a really good talk in the early hour and some good sports talk. Y'all guys, take care. Be safe. And if you can't be safe, please be careful. This has been Pearly. I'm out.
Play with Island Games.
We making dreams come true.
Play with Island Games.
We paying more out to you. Don't mind the noise in the market. You get cash in your pocket.
Cause Island Games is spicy and spicy is tradition.
So when you play
Island Games,
we putting Bahamian's voice guaranteed to pay.
Island Games.
We like them mother jokers. We've been here from the start, from the bike to computer.
Island Games.
We gonna make your dreams come true.
We playing with Island Games.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is now City of Hope, creating one of the leading cancer care and research networks from coast to coast, providing more of what you need. More locations means more care closer to home. More specialists means more expertise. More research means more breakthroughs. More advancements means more treatment options. And more options means more hope. Learn more at cancercenter.com.
John's Department Store January sale has begun, and you don't want to miss out on our greatest savings event of the year. 25% off all items, appliances included, except Timberland and Sperry brand items, which are 15% off. And don't forget our nursing, hospitality, and chef uniform store, John's Carewear, as well as our women's fashion store, John's Fast Fashion, which is also 25% off everything. Whatever your footwear and fashion needs, come into John's in Palmdale or Carmichael Road this January 27th through February 3rd to start the year off right. John's, we put fashion at your feet.
All right, time to evaluate the Miami Dolphins draft big board because we know this time of year it's constantly changing. And oh yes, this is the type of roll up your sleeves draft, make it or break it draft for Chris Greer. And taking a look at the Miami Dolphins draft board in 2024, there's a lot of positions of need to address. And there's a lot of different directions Miami can go with the assets that they have in their current draft capital, because when you think about where this team has been in the past as far as draft capital, this is a welcome sight in 2024 because they've got a first-round pick. How about that? Exceptional stuff. There's a couple of picks missing from the Miami Dolphins because of the trade with Bradley Chubb. But overall, this is draft capital that the Miami Dolphins can make the most of. So as we look to what this team has, you see they got the number 21 overall pick and then the 23rd selection in the second round, which equates to the 55th overall pick. They forfeited that round 3 pick. Thanks a lot for the tampering. Not good. Round 4, don't have a pick there either because that was traded in the Bradley Chubb deal. Then they're back on the board in round 5 with the 23rd selection, which is 156 overall, and 2 in round 6. Remember, that was part of a trade as well. And then in round 7, they've got the 21st selection, 238 overall. So 6 total picks in 2024. And we look back to what Chris Greer did in 2023. A couple of swings and misses, if we're being honest, but also a home run pick in the 3rd round there with the star rookie running back Devon Achane, really the only pick that salvaged this draft for Chris Greer. So a lot on the table, as there always is when it comes to the NFL draft. And because only one of those picks worked out from a year ago, and maybe Cam Smith will work out. Maybe he will. With the new defensive coordinator, new system, this, that, and the other, maybe he gets an opportunity. But right now, the only pick from 2023 that worked out is Devon Achane. And so because of that, I think it's important for Chris Greer and the front office to really lock it in, dial it in, and obviously that's pointing out the obvious, but they got to come through in the 2024 draft. They have to learn from their mistakes they made last year and be ready to go in 2024. And so when you think about that, you got to start to think as a fan, what's your confidence level in Chris Greer in company? So let me know down in the comments. Scale it for me, 1 through 10, your confidence level in the general manager, Chris Greer's drafting ability. He's shown some hits, but he's also shown some misses. So let me know what that confidence level is down in the comments. Scale it for me, 1 through 10. Now, I think because Chris Greer has hit on a couple of draft picks, and maybe Cam Smith will in fact turn out, I think I'm not ready to close the book on Chris Greer the way some people are. I still have moderate confidence in him. Let's say a 5 right down the middle, but I'll say it again. This is a make it or break it year for Chris Greer to prove that he has the ability to draft meaningful impact players that make contributions from day one. That's we're seeing in the NFL. That's how you build teams. You get the players on those cheaper rookie deals that can be substantial impact players on the field as first-year players, second-year players, third-year players, and so on and so forth, and you build that young core through the draft. So hopefully Chris Greer is able to do that. Now, coming up, we've got a CBS Sports first-round mock draft to get into. We'll also mock a second-round pick as well for you. But first, guys, I got to tell you about these Fanatics Dolphins gear. I know it's the offseason, but the NFL Jam T-shirts never go out of style. I picked one up the other day. They are awesome. And we've got a special code, special link for you that we'll put in the comments and description of today's video so you can use that chat sports code for us. But I'm telling you, whether it be the new school NFL Jam t-shirts or the old school ones are timeless as well with the NFL Blitz Dan Marino t-shirt, you got to snag one for yourself at Fanatics, the best and one-stop shop for exclusive Miami Dolphins gear. Now, CBS Sports mock draft. It's important, again, to obviously I'm telling you what you already know, but this is a mock draft. This is one guy's opinion. Josh Edwards, who writes for CBS Sports, has Troy Fatanu out of Washington going to Miami as the number 21 overall pick. Now, if you've been following us all offseason, you know we've done a couple of mock drafts already, and Troy Fatanu is a guy's name that keeps coming up. And why not? He played extremely well the past season at Washington, who, if you don't follow college football, you probably still know that Washington made it all the way to the national championship game before losing to Michigan. And they had a tremendous offense with Michael Penix Jr., a load of wide receiver weapons, including Rome Odunze. And regardless of how good your skill players are, you got to have the offensive linemen. And Troy Fatanu anchored that Washington offensive line. He was a third-team All-American selection. But what's also telling about his abilities is what Mel Kiper, the draft expert, had to say about Troy Fatanu, saying he allowed two career sacks on nearly 1,250 pass-blocking snaps. That's a pretty good percentage. It wouldn't shock me if a team drafted Fatanu to play tackle, but I see all-pro upside for him at guard. So it's kind of a luxury to draft a guy that has the versatility to play multiple positions. And when you look at his Pro Football Focus grades as a tackle for Washington in 2023, overall 75, but that pass blocking grade is impressive, 88.2. The run blocking can improve, of course, but this is a team that threw the ball all the time. Over 70% of the snaps from Washington were passing the football, and he only allowed two sacks. That is incredible stuff. And when you think about the positional needs for the Dolphins, offensive line is certainly at the top of the list because this is the Dolphins' offensive line that was banged up all season long. And when you start to think about where this Dolphins front office can plug and play a little bit with the draft picks, offensive line is an important spot to be in, because the Dolphins are expected to be around over $40 million over the cap, so it's important to start plugging those rookie deals in with impact players that can make meaningful contributions, starting with that 21st overall pick in the draft. And who knows, maybe you go offensive line in the draft, and then you have the ability to say goodbye to guys like Connor Williams, Robert Hunt, guys that are free agents on the offensive line, because you've replaced them with viable players on the offensive line through the draft. But that's just one potential strategy. Now, you look at the Dolphins' offensive line. They were banged up all season long. They have 12 different starting combinations. And as I mentioned, Robert Hunt and Connor Williams are both free agents. So who's to say if they'll be back or not? And in a lot of ways, the Dolphins' offensive line overperformed or outperformed some of their expectations. But one area, they were not great in the pass block win rate. You see that? 31st in the NFL out of 32 teams in pass block win rate. That needs to improve, and Troy Fatanu could be a guy to help you do just that. Now, also, other options for the Miami Dolphins at offensive line, or just prospects from the offensive line. We've talked about Jaxson Powers-Johnson, the guard center out of Oregon. J.C. Latham is another guy that a lot of draft experts have mocked to Miami in that first round. And don't forget about Talese Fuaga out of Oregon State. He's an offensive tackle that showed great athleticism for his size. And Jordan Morgan, an offensive tackle from Arizona, also very athletic for his size as well. But for me, I think your top two candidates there are Jaxson Powers-Johnson or Troy Fatanu. Both guys, to me, scream first-round talent. They scream versatility, athleticism, plug-and-play guys on the offensive line. And if last year's any indication, there's a lot of times where offensive linemen will be called to play different positions. So having that ability to cross-train, whether it be Liam Eikenberg playing center or stepping in at guard, whatever it may be, there were times where Dolphins offensive linemen had to play multiple spots on that O-line. So both Fatanu and Jaxson Powers-Johnson have proven they have the ability to do so. But you be the GM with me for a second. Who's your pick for the Dolphins in the first round? Let me know down in the comments. Would love to hear what you have to say on this one. Now, I want to get into our second round mock draft. Before we do that, it's important to note that the Miami Dolphins, again, have that second-round pick, and it's also important to note that with that second-round pick, you can't miss because there's no pick in the third round as of now, and there's no pick in the fourth round. So crucial to get that second-round pick correct. Now, Pro Football Focus came out with a five-round mock draft by Trevor Sikkema, and he had Jaxson Powers-Johnson falling all the way to the Dolphins at 55, which to me would be a dream scenario. I don't think that's going to happen. I really think Jaxson Powers-Johnson will be selected before the second round. I think he's a first-round talent. But we'll know more after the scouting combine and, of course, the Senior Bowl as well. But if he falls all the way to pick number 55 and the Dolphins can swoop him up there, I'm all for it. Now, Dane Brugler of The Athletic saw the Dolphins going in a different direction. He had them taking Edgerrin Cooper, an athletic outside linebacker, edge rusher type from Texas A&M in the second round with the 55th pick overall. And based on the injury bug at the defensive end edge rusher position for the Dolphins, maybe shoring up that component of the depth chart would be important. Jalen Phillips having a breakout year. He was one of the Dolphins' last first-round picks. In fact, the Dolphins' last two first-round picks are Jalen Phillips and Jalen Waddle. So they've kind of hit two home runs there. Bradley Chubb also has been a great defensive edge player. After coming over from Denver, he was having a breakout season before he got hurt. Andrew Van Ginkle's a free agent, so question mark there. But we know he improved his level of play as well. So maybe Edgerrin Cooper could be added to the edge roster in the second round of the draft, because this Dolphins defense thrived when they were able to get pressure on the opposing quarterbacks last year in 2023. In fact, they finished with the third most sacks and the second best sack rate in the NFL. So if Edgerrin Cooper is the guy and can help that, I'm also for that as well. But I want to know what you think. Do you want the Dolphins to go offense or defense, O or D, in the second round? If it's an offensive player you want, type O. If you want them to switch back to the defensive side of the ball, type D. Either way, let me know down in the comments. And as I stated, my opinion is we'll know more after the Senior Bowl that's going on right now. And, of course, the scouting combine, where we learn a lot more about how these players can test out and, of course, perform the various tests at the combine. And I think as that starts to go on and progress, we start to narrow our focus as the Dolphins and determine who will be the best player to fit the aqua and orange in the first and second round, and every pick for that matter. So, as always, we want to continue to grow here on Dolphins Today. And we've experienced all kinds of tremendous growth throughout the season. That's a testament to each and every one of you. But as we do here at Chat Sports, we're setting up a goal to go even further. We're getting lackadaisical or complacent. In fact, we're striving for more. So help us reach our goal that we've set, 58,000 subscribers by the end of February. Tell a Dolphins friend. I know you guys have a lot of friends out there. And if you've already subscribed, thank you. But tell a friend. Tell a neighbor, tell a sibling, cousin, aunt, uncle, whatever it is. We want to continue to see our channel grow, because the more subscribers, the more Dolphins content, the more live shows, and covering the aqua and orange from every angle is our passion here on Dolphins Today. So subscribe to the channel and let's continue to grow.
Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.